New tonight, a family with ties to Colorado still overseas after barely making it out of Israel.
Now the family tells Fox 31 reporter Samantha Spitz that they crossed over the border just in time. It's a story you'll see only here on Fox 31. Samantha.
Yes, some stressful moments for this couple. Ann and Randy Vrabel are related to a member of our Fox 31 staff and were in Israel with their church at the time of the Hamas attack. The two say they were able to cross into Jordan safely, but it's an experience they won't ever forget.
It was scary.
From the safety of their hotel room.
We're in Amman, Jordan right now.
Ann and Randy Vrabel recount the day their trip to the Holy Land took an unexpected turn.
They told us that there had been an attack and that Israel was at war and they didn't know what was going to happen. So they thought the Dead Sea would be a safe place to go to.
The two were in Nazareth with their church group at the time of the bombings and quickly made their way to the Dead Sea, first crossing through the West Bank.
While we were there, refugees were coming in to stay there, refugees from the Gaza Strip area that were affected by the violence.
Once they reached the border to cross over into Jordan, Ann says they weren't sure they were going to get through.
It took us 4.5 hours, and we finally got through, and we found out that they closed it shortly after we got through, and it hasn't reopened since. There was some tears, and it was scary, but I can't say that we have ever felt unsafe here.
The two say they feel fortunate.
You know, there's a lot of trouble and conflict and divisiveness in the U.S., but we don't live under constant fear and threat of attack.
Now praying for a safe return back home.
We are ready. It'll be nice to be home.
Say they will fly back to the U.S. out of Jordan on Sunday. In the meantime, they are safe and say they're going to make the best out of their time there. In studio, Samantha Spitz, Fox 31.
Yeah, wishing